Friday on X-Play. Our regular programming gets carjacked by Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Holy parental advisory warnings, Batman. Things are about to get violent. Can we even show that? It's game time. Warning! This program is not suitable for children, pregnant women, or Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
I don't think any pregnant women watch our show.
And they should never handle broken episodes. Hello and welcome to this special edition of X-Play. Now, normally we rally with dozens of harshly critical and occasionally stupid game reviews.
But today, we've devoted an entire show to Grand Theft Auto San Andreas and the cult of GTA.
This is, hands down, the biggest PlayStation 2 game of the year.
May even be the biggest game of the year. Except maybe Halo 2.
It's also the most controversial.
Yes, it raises issues about video game violence, the portrayal of minorities in games, ESRB ratings, and online piracy.
And chances are that it'll be the best-selling game of the year.
Now, later in the show, we'll have our first hands-on look at GTA San Andreas. But before we go any further, let's take a look at the official trailer for the little game that's making everybody, from fans to politicians, totally freak out.
Bah!
Moaning in that trailer. I hope that lady's okay.
The Grand Theft Auto Vice City was set in 1980s Miami Vice era. San Andreas is set in the West Coast gangsta scene of the 90s.
And once again, fans of the series will be rewarded with another GTA soundtrack culled from the hits of that era.
Songs like Welcome to the Jungle, Nothing But a G Thing, White Wedding, and Freebird. Yes? Freebird.
Yeah, well, it's also Poisoned by Belle Biv DeVoe. That's the first time the words Belle Biv DeVoe have escaped my lips in 10 years.
Let's keep it that way. Yeah. Of course, in an ironic twist, much like Halo 2, an illegal version of San Andreas has been stolen and pirated onto the internet.
And Rockstar is furious, which is kind of funny considering that their game is about stealing stuff.
However, thousands of fans will be getting San Andreas the old-fashioned way, lining up outside a game store after dark on the night of its release. So we're here at EB Games in Universal City, and we're about to see one of the launches of one of the biggest games of 2004, perhaps ever. Wrong start. What's the first thing you're gonna do when you pop this game in and you can actually start playing it?
I'm actually gonna try starting missions.
You're actually gonna try starting missions?
Yeah.
You're not gonna just go beat up a hooker or something?
No.
Exploring.
You're gonna explore? Are you looking for treasure?
Kick the crap out of people, yeah.
Okay, now we're talking with some honesty. You've been playing Grand Theft Auto for a long time, right?
I've never played it in my life.
I'm excited.
You're just so excited you've gotten, like, you're quiet with excitement. Do you feel like you're part of an elite clique of consumers?
Yeah, it's good to be here. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this, big time.
Do you know what the game is about?
Nope.
I'm going to
play the game.
I'm gonna give you a clue. It's called Grand Theft Auto.
Okay.
What do you think it's about?
Stealing?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I'll probably hit a couple of people.
There we go. Yeah. What is the first thing you're gonna do in the game?
Make the fattest guy possible.
All right, the magic hour is here. It is now 7 p.m. Now all these gamers that have been outside are be coming in here hoping to be. Do I mean, do you like the game? Is the game good? Yeah. Do you like the game? I mean, what have you done so far? You haven't tried it? Have you ever gotten to a car with him right after he's been playing the game?
I'm the one who drives.
That's a very good idea. What do you think now? Do you think the game's good now?
Yeah, I do.
All right, do you think it's going to be good in an hour? I could have sworn the game was about beating people in the head and having illicit sex, but maybe I was wrong. You know, for a game that glorifies violence, its fans are really good at waiting patiently in line.
Of course, this is the first GTA game with an African-American protagonist. And since the game is basically about stealing cars, breaking into houses, and, you know, killing people, some community leaders are understandably upset.
But is this more of an industry-wide problem? Well, for starters, the only recent black protagonists of note were the convicted murderer in The Suffering, the violent wrestling rappers of the Def Jam series, and the cops who shoot everyone in Bad Boys Miami Takedown.
Well, you can also play as Snoop Dogg in True Crime Streets of L.A. Of course, in that game, he mostly steals cars and shoots people.
Well, that's why, in the name of fairness, and to show that there isn't some sort of weird industry bias, we chose some of the gaming industry's more favorable minority characters.
And now, positive African-American role models in video games.
There's the guy from Half-Life.
Please, leave me alone.
And, there's... No, Oh, there...
This was positive African-American role models in video games. Up next, more Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Why? Because we can! Warning, contains explicit content and Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to this all-GTA episode of X-Play.
That's right. Today, we're devoting an entire show to one of the biggest video game releases of the year, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
It's violent, expletive-laden, and you can kill hoes in it. So, of course, everyone wants to buy it.
Including gamers who are underage. Now, what should you do if you're 14 and you want to steal cars virtually? Seek help and watch this instructional video.
Hi, I'm X-Play's Dr. Friendly, and this is X-Play's Hypothetical Lab. Why hypothetical? Well, after our expose on whether baboons make good babysitters, the DOH, SPCA, OSHA, and Child Protective Services gave us a little talk. Baboons can be so unpredictable. But why linger on dismemberment when we can talk about the newest members of society's up-and-coming underclass? Youth! This is Timmy. Timmy is happy because Grand Theft Auto San Andreas just hit store shelves. But Timmy is sad because he can't buy it all by himself. But all he needs is the assistance of a responsible adult, like Timmy's mom. So he asks her.
Ooh. Mom, would you buy me Grand Theft Auto San Andreas?
No, you're gonna turn into a moral reprobate if you play that before the age of 18. Ooh.
Uh-oh, Timmy, you need a new tactic. How about changing Grand Theft Auto to something more parentally tantalizing? Now GTA means gather the animals, grooving the alphabet, get the abacus, and our favorite, good time Amish. Let's see how it works.
Oh. Mom, would you buy me the new GTA?
GTA? Now, what does that stand for?
Good Time Amish.
You do need some antiquated fanaticism in your life. There's $50 in my purse.
Look who's on his way to some good old-fashioned adult mayhem. But sometimes Mom is a little too informed.
Here it says is that all you do is kill Haitian hookers with baseball bats while flying planes into buildings.
So now you have to go it alone into your own local den of iniquity, the game store.
GTA, please?
Hell no, young man. You have to be exactly 18 years of age or older to handle this cultural plutonium. Uh-oh, Timmy. Looks like you're too young. Time to get old. A little ingenuity and granddad's back hair has transformed our little upstart consumer into an emblem of maturity. Let's see how it works.
GTA, please.
Why, it would be an honor to sell that game to such a distinguished captain of industry as yourself. Or why not capitalize on our current infatuation with urban heroism?
GTA, please.
How can I deny mass carnage to one who so valiantly holds society together? Or you can try to impress them with social fabulousness.
Yay.
Fabulous.
GTA, please.
Your rakish charm is almost too much to bear. Enjoy your adult fun. Or better yet, become a doppelganger of one of the industry's leading authorities.
GTA, please.
Yeah, it's over there. Hey, I liked you better before you changed the show. Well, little Timmy, are you ready to pull out that manual and read about all the fun you're gonna have?
Yes, but Mr. Sessler, I can't read.
Of course, Timmy. Of course.
You know, as a woman, you make Tootsie look like Anna Kournikova. Did you rob a wig shop?
No, man, rob.
It's all the same in the morally questionable universe of Grand Theft Auto.
Which is why you should stick around, because later we have our hands-on first look at Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Or Golly, That's American for the moms out there.
Up next, a GTA clone that's twice as offensive as the original. Really? Warning, may cause nausea. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to this all GTA X-Play.
Later in the show, we have our hands-on first look at GTA San Andreas.
But first, let's talk about the impact Grand Theft Auto has had on the industry.
Its success has spawned dozens of clones and imitators.
Games like Driver 3, True Crime Streets of L.A.
And even Simpsons Hit and Run, Spider-Man 2, and Tony Hawk's Underground 2. They've all adopted the Grand Theft Auto freeform approach.
But none of them have ripped off the GTA style quite as much as Midway's Roadkill.
And does it hold a candle to GTA? Find out in our re-review of Roadkill.
Oh, so much for an easy fight.
What do you do when you have a game that doesn't do anything new and you want it to stand out from the other games that don't do anything original? A, do something original.
Go for the bumper car.
Yeah, right. B, slather it with profanity and violence.
Tell me the name.
Guess what? The makers of Roadkill chose B. I know, crazy, isn't it? So, as an amateur sociologist, I decided to find out if I was cooler if I used potty talk.
Hey there, you big. What? What the hell did you just call me?
Hey there, you f***ing dog. Hey, how are my two favorite doing?
Head.
Plug.
What the fuck? Right after your ears stop bleeding, you'll notice that Roadkill is about driving around and killing people with your automotive death machine. Kind of like Twisted Metal. But it takes place in expansive cities and is mission-based, all the while using a very familiar mini-map and font scheme. Yep, you got the 10-cent question. It's Grand Theft Auto 3. Catch is, those games are great. Roadkill isn't.
Just keep firing!
It's just a rip-off that produces a functional game and nothing more. What's the story, you say? You play Mason.
The name's Mason.
A good, tough name. He goes to Hell County. That's a dumbass name. He wants to be taken down to Paradise City. Oh, that's so clever. But he's got to kill a whole lot of foe to reach his urban salvation. The game has over 40 different cars, and there's a nice range of armaments to blaze a trail of widows and orphans with. And if you haven't already gathered, the game relishes any moment to indulge in scenes of extreme violence.
Ooh, it's written in blood.
It uses the profanity with the dexterity of a 7-year-old.
What does he think I am? F***ing Mother Teresa, a f***ing Boy Scout.
And loves talk radio programs hosted by crude stereotypes.
We just love weddings, free booze, lots of hot drunk guys in tuxedos.
But you know what? I've gone down this road before, and it's as if the developers think that with enough profanity and sadism, I'll never notice that the game is uninspired and dull because I'll be so thrilled that it's obscene and crass. Well, you know, some people might go for it.
Duh.
All right,
here we go.
In copying Twisted Metal, Roadkill does a pretty good job, but it's nowhere close to the fun of Grand Theft Auto. But if you're over 18 and have the sophistication of an 8-year-old, this might go well with your beer-splatted tank top. A 2 out of 5.
Talk to you.
Yeah, you can talk to me. Yep, nothing. No matter how vulgar, quite lives up to the original.
And Grand Theft Auto, whose game engine first appeared back in Body Harvest for the N64, is finally getting a total revamp with GTA San Andreas. Now that means instead of drowning every time you hit the water, now you can swim.
That's novel. And we'll show you everything else Grand Theft Auto San Andreas has to offer when we come back.
You think it'll have hose?
Oh, no, what?
Up next, this is it! Our first look at Grand Theft Auto San Andreas! Once again, two people who love carjacking, Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
It's a great way to meet people. Welcome back to the special edition of X-Play.
That's right, we have come to the moment everyone with a PS2 has been waiting for. Our first hands-on look at San Andreas.
You've heard rumors about what it's going to look like, how it's going to play, and what the new features will be.
Now it's time to find out what's really in San Andreas.
Here's our hands-on preview of the biggest PS2 game of the year, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Is that it? Mm-hmm.
I'm going to hit y'all with this brand new Dr. Dre, nothing but a G thing, featuring Snoop Dogg. Y'all know the sound of the West Coast.
1, 2. Bringing to the folks, Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the dope.
Sorry, Snoop, it's not GTA faux time yet, but it is time for Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. It's 1992. After 5 years away from the hood, Carl Johnson returns to Los Santos to avenge the murder of his mother by gangbangers.
CJ. Oh my God, what's up?
His reunion with his Grove Street homies is bittersweet at best.
Things are going real bad. Here, let me show you running, man. Tony's buried over there. Little devil over there. It's big devil over there. Man, it's just crazy.
You don't even want to know what happened to Medium Devil. CJ jumps back into the gangsta life with both feet and begins the long, difficult process of reclaiming the Grove Street gang's former glory.
Give up the money. This a raid.
Ryder, not this again.
You ain't me, fool.
No one else is that small. I feel sorry for your dad.
GTA San Andreas is so much bigger than its predecessors, it's almost overwhelming. Instead of just one city, as in previous GTA games, San Andreas is a fictionalized version of California.
Let's face it, the Midwest is full of retards.
What you're seeing in this first look is all from Los Santos, the GTA version of Los Angeles. We'd love to show you San Fierro and Las Venturas, but after 10 hours of playtime, we still hadn't finished all the Los Santos missions. Yeah, it's that big. At its core, the gameplay in San Andreas is unchanged.
Get a vehicle up now.
You steal cars, drive like a maniac, gun down enemies and innocents, and harass the police at every turn. But this time, the cities you'll traverse are packed with things to do and ways to customize CJ's skills and appearance. CJ starts as a skinny guy in a wife beater, but you're quickly given the ability to change your hair and clothing. Of course, what you look like does impact how people react to you. Better. And your friends will pull no punches when it comes to your looks.
You jacked up. Man, what's this? This look ridiculous.
You now have to eat once in a while to keep your strength up, and a wise gangster wannabe will hit the gym regularly to build muscle and stamina. You can get tattoos, mod your car, participate in lowrider competitions, and even break into houses to steal valuables for cash.
Gee, I got it ninja style. Why? Come out, you old bastard!
Shut up!
And your mind will definitely be on your money much of the time. Missions don't automatically give you cash anymore. Often, you'll slowly earn respect as you complete more tasks.
You couldn't pay me enough to get in that piece of
very slowly.
Come on in, homeboy, hit me!
CJ has an expanded repertoire of punches, and the newly tweaked targeting system makes firefights far less frustrating. His fence-hopping skills make backyard dead ends a thing of the past.
Oh, you better knock me out.
The setting means GTA San Andreas will give any Tarantino film a run for its money in the expletive department.
Man, I don't give a shit. I'm gangsta.
But it also means you'll have a fantastic soundtrack to cruise to. You'll also notice a boost in graphics, and the acting is better than ever.
Look at you. You dress like a hooker.
Oh, and I guess you two would know what a hooker look like, huh?
You say it like it's a bad thing.
Shut up, Carl.
And we can't forget everyone's favorite GTA pastime, eavesdropping on pedestrians.
The liverwurst was green, but I ate it anyway.
Did somebody just say milkshake?
I smoke because it gives me knowledge.
I want to watch you fly. Welcome to the jungle. We're taking
barely even scratched the surface of GTA San Andreas, but it looks to be worth the wait.
I'm too intelligent for this sh- man.
Don't hate. That's no way to talk about the biggest PS2 game of the year.
Well, don't go roll a damn car over and blow us all up in flames then.
Touche. Look for our full review soon. In the meantime, enjoy the ride.
You know where you are!
So go forth, pick up your own copy of GTA, and be fruitful.
We'll be back with our full review as soon as we can drag ourselves away from playing San Andreas long enough to write it.
We done?
Good night. Bye.
We'll be right back.